make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love.
St. Francis, sung so beautifully by Sarah McLaughlin. Why? Because today is the feast day of St. Francis of Assisi. So to all our Franciscan brothers and sisters out there, including our very own Sister Carolyn, blessings of joy upon you. And for all of us as we gather in prayer here at the God Minute, so glad you're with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 126. Begin in praise. Let us begin this day with rejoicing. Let us acknowledge our Lord's love and concern, and allow our bodies to break forth into joyful noise.
The Lord has done such wonderful things for us. Let us be glad. The day before us is uncertain. We don't know what we will encounter on our way.
Wherever we go forth as children and servants of the living God. We go forth to touch the lives of men and women with His healing love and words of kindness.
Let us begin this day with rejoicing and return to our homes with gladness in the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 11, verses 28 to 30. Jesus said to his disciples, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, and my burden light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today, our Lord speaks to us of the rewards of obedience. When Christ speaks of his yoke, he is referring to his gospel or the new law. God gave the Israelites the Ten Commandments and other laws in the Old Testament as part of his providence and loving will for his people. But over time, as his people continued to disobey God's laws, Jewish leaders added many different prescriptions and responsibilities to them. By the time of Christ, it was overbearing and challenging for people to observe the laws commanded to them. Now, the Pharisees were responsible for enforcing all of these added laws. Today, Jesus teaches us that his law, the law of the gospel, leads us to true freedom. That is, it leads us to rest from all sinfulness, shame, and guilt. Many people today see the laws and regulations of the church as a burden or as obstacles to our freedom and our joy. Now, this is what the evil one wants us all to believe. But Christ teaches us today that his teachings, communicated by the church throughout the centuries, lead to true spiritual freedom and the fullness of joy and flourishing. I know I need a constant reminder of this in my life. One regulation of the church that I found increasingly difficult to understand was the obligation to attend Mass every Sunday and holy days of obligation. I would ask myself, does God really care if everyone goes to Mass on those days? Can't we just worship him in nature or with our families instead of having to sit through Mass? I began to talk with people about this law's purpose and began to recognize how it communicates the same message that Jesus teaches us today. God commands us to participate at Mass each week and on holy days for our benefit, not his. He knows that it is what is best for us. God wants us to spend just a short time each week with him in his house so he can pour out his love and mercy on us, to teach us the right way to live and unite with us in Holy Communion. This law or obligation certainly brings spiritual freedom rather than restricting it. St. Francis of Assisi modeled obedience to God and his church for each of us. Francis was willing to sacrifice everything out of obedience to God because he trusted that God wanted nothing but the best for him. When the Lord commanded Francis to rebuild his church, Francis obeyed. He was willing to sacrifice all sorts of riches and fortunes. He was even willing to sacrifice his own relationship with his father, who pushed Francis to a life of wealth, fame, and success. Francis's life and obedience exemplify for each of us that obedience to God and his church leads us to happiness and lasting fulfillment. Let us all imitate Francis and obediently take up the yoke of Christ's gospel in our lives today. Let the name of Jesus be praised, both now and forever. Amen.
And as Jesus taught us, we pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
And let us pray. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love, as you love me. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thanks for being with us today. Happy feast day once again, all you Francises, and maybe in his spirit,
Let's go outside in nature at some point today. Take off your shoes and socks and just drag your feet through the grass or the changing leaves and just say thank you, God. Thank you. And may this God bless you now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Have a beautiful day, friends. See you tomorrow.
Yeah.